Bismillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. My dear beautiful people, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is your brother Abdus Salam Abu Hanifa. Your value where you live right now does not depend on what you already know. The value, your true value, depends on what you act upon. It is worldly and widely known today that any knowledge upon which you do not act is actually not knowledge. For instance, you know that driving past 30 miles an hour is an offense. So that is knowledge. Well, what is expected of you is that when you drive, you don't go beyond 30 miles an hour. If you drive past that speed limit, you get a ticket. The ticket is for what? Is it because you don't know or you didn't act upon that which you knew? Well, it's because you didn't act upon that which you knew. Islam takes the same approach when it comes to knowledge and to action. There is no point in knowing a lot when your actions are not a lot. There must be a great balance there. This is why on the day of Al-Qiyamah, the very first man that will go into Jahannam, the very first one, Jahannam is totally empty. It's not a shaitan. The first one is not any kafir or any disbeliever or anything. The very first man to go into hellfire is a knowledgeable person in Islam, a sheikh or a da'i or a caller or someone who preaches or a ustad, whoever. What's his sin? He told people to do things and he himself broke the line. He tells them don't do that and he does it. So much so that in another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam talks about this scientific or this sheikh or this da'i or this ustad or this hotshot YouTube dude. When they see him in Jahannam, wal'ayadu billah, his belly has exploded and his intestines around, and he turns around them as a donkey would turn around a mill. They would say, Subhanallah, what are you doing here? You used to tell us about doing good and you forbade us about evil. Well, in that moment there, my brothers and my sisters, there is no need to hide anything. He would say to them, as reported by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I used to command you to do good and I didn't do it. And I used to forbade you from doing evil and I did it. So there is a huge responsibility on those who know and preach. Does that mean me only and the other people? No. It also means you. Every time you talk about Islam to somebody and you praise Islam in a manner and you don't practice it, on the day of Qiyamah, you will receive the punishment for that because you said that which you didn't do. My brothers and my sisters, we live in a time that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has warned and has warned and has warned against taking certain steps towards knowledge, because we live in a time where lies are easily spread and there is also a huge lack of knowledge authentication. Many times people send me an hadith, fabricated a hadith they received from somebody here or there, and alhamdulillah these people are good people because they want to double check. This is one of the reasons why I forbade the posting of anything into these groups that I run. Various reasons. Number one is I protect your knowledge and I am responsible for what you get from my end. If a knowledge is wrong, then I will answer to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. And I want to go to Jannah. I don't want to put my life to perish. When someone posts something in the group and you guys read it, like the other day, somebody posts something about McDonald's and that is absolutely wrong. And then about this drink and then do this and do that. So when you go and practice it and do it, you will do evil. Why? Because you heard it from this group here and I didn't say anything. So you must take it for an authentic act, only to turn over later that it is not. Then on the day of Qiyamah, Allah will ask you about the knowledge. Where did you get it from and what did you do with it? And I acted ignorantly is not an excuse. A shaitan takes advantage of these days. And he takes big, huge advantage. Look at this beautiful hadith reported in Sahih Muslim. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَيَتَمَثَّلُ فِي سُورَةِ الرَّجُلِ. A shaitan will morph into the image of a man, i.e. he will appear as a man. فَيَأْتِي الْقَوْمِ. Then he will come to a people. فَيُحَدِّثُهُمْ بِالْحَدِيثِ مِنَ الْكَذِبِ. And then he talks to them or he preaches to them a preaching or a knowledge made of pure lies. فَيَتَفَرَّقُونَ. And then they will disperse. فَيَقُولُ الرَّجُلُ مِنْهُمْ. A man amongst them would say, سَمِعْتُ رَجُلًا. I've heard a man. I know his face. أعرف وجهه ولا أدري ما اسمه. يحدث. I know his face, but I don't know what his name is, saying what the knowledge that I am bringing to you. And this hadith, as I mentioned, is in Sahih Muslim. Here is a great, huge danger. And now you understand why every time I talk, every time I make a pep talk, I put my name at the beginning of my pep talk or my talk or my lesson or anything, and at the end with my phone number. It's the application of this hadith. Because a shaitan today comes to people to us, and he could be on YouTube preaching, believe it or not. And he will morph in a picture of a man. And then he will come to us or we go to him. And he will talk to us some sweet talkings, talk knowledge, and he will put into it a lot of poisonous knowledge. People will disperse from him. And a man, as I said, as Rasulullah said, I heard a man that I know his face, but I don't know his name, preaching this or gave this talk. For the love of Allah, and the people you listen to on YouTube or that you get their clips of, what do you know about them? How do you know it is not a shaitan playing a trick on you? Look at the other hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, also in Sahih Muslim. Says, قال, إِنَّ فِي الْبَحْرِ شَيَاطِينَ مَسْجُولَةَ أَوْثَقَهَا سُلَيْمَانَ. In the oceans, there are jailed shayateen, devils, that have been chained or prisoned by Sulaiman, and he tied them up with chains. يُوشِكُ أَن تَخْرُجُ. It is about time that they come out, and this is 1400 years ago. فَتَقْرَأُ عَلَى النَّاسِ قُرْآنًا. And they will read upon people a Qur'an. Something that would sound like a Qur'an, but it is not Qur'an. So in this hadith of Muslim, Rasulullah expressly says that there are some devils and shayateen that have been punished by Sulaiman alayhi salam, and he chained them and exiled them to islands in the oceans or in the oceans. And when the time is due, they will come out. Allah Ta'ala will authorize them to come out. And what will they do? They will preach unto a man a Quran. Quran does not mean the Quran, the book of Allah. Quran is a knowledge that yuqra, that is read out to people. Today we hear a lot of people that attack Islam from different angles. We don't know who these people are. We have no idea. Yet they come up with some things that you think, whoa, what is this thing here? Well, my brothers and my sisters, let me tell you something that is painful to know. Tons of people out there get their knowledge from these kind of people, the shayateen. Either Iblis himself, who would come and preach as a man, or those prison shayateen that come out from the islands. YouTube is not a source of seeking knowledge. A sheikh, Google, is not an authority in knowledge. If you are a Joe Public or a Abdullah Public, don't you go to YouTube and seek knowledge. Sometimes I go there and listen to YouTube. Wallahi, I hear things. If you believe in them, you will go to disbelief. يَقْرَأُونَ عَلَى النَّاسِ قُرْآنَ. These translated meanings of Al-Quran. I swear to Allah, and I pray to Allah that I am correct. I am so sure that the shayateen have done a job. What do you know about Yusuf Ali? Do you know that Yusuf Ali was a Shia? There are others. I was the other day compiling a history on the translation of the meanings of the Quran. On 100% of the people that have done it, 95% are not people of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah that have translated. So someone says, but they are making it easy for me. I'm sorry. A shaitan, when he came out, as Rasulullah ﷺ says, when he comes out in the picture of a man, in the image of a man, and he will preach, he's not going to tell you associate with Allah and give him a son. He's already secured this kind of people. What is he going to do to you? He's going to translate actions. Wear blue jeans, tight blue jeans, just put something on your head and call it a hijab. And you, my brother, have a beard like a map on your face and have the footballer haircut. Cut right and cut left. And then that is okay with Islam. And you, with the other one there, it's okay to say, Allah says in Al-Quran, O you who believe, O mankind, we have created you from a man and a woman. And that is okay to lie on behalf of Allah. And you who says, the Prophet ﷺ says, don't do this and don't do that in English. How do you know it is not a shaitan? You can't go back to the original texts. You can't go back to the original text to double check what a shaitan is lying to you. We live in a time where a shaitan comes, lies a lie, and it will hit the end of the world. One day someone came to me and spoke about a sheikh, well-known sheikh in Saudi Arabia. And he says, this sheikh is being labeled as a homosexual. And I said to him, Subhanallah, is this, how did you hear it? Was it like the group of scholars? Who said this? Today, it's very easy to attack people, Muslims, scholars. One day, someone sends me a picture, the name of Sheikh Mohammed Hassan. May Allah protect him. This great Sheikh, subhanAllah. Bin Baz and Ibn Uthaymeen, great Sheikhs, Al-Albani, great Sheikh. So many great Sheikhs, subhanAllah, nowadays are evil. When we start naming names and we say they are evil, then that's it. Who are we going to take the knowledge from? Of the things, my brothers and my sisters, of the signs of the hour, as reported in Kitab al-Zuhd by Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak and authenticated by Sheikh Nasruddin al-Albani, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that at the end of the time, knowledge will be sought from the general public, not from the people who sought knowledge, not from the knowledgeable people. Knowledge will be sought and taken from general public, al-asaghir. Today, we get clips. I get sometimes clips with the Quran. Behind it is some piano music, subhanAllah. And then the Quran is being recited with a background of music. And other parts, the hadith, someone else translates the text in from Arabic to English and with no mentioning of the Arabic at all. So much so that you believe Islam is in English. Truncated clips. They take a small clip from a whole talk and that's it. And they build a whole concept in Islam around that particularity. And this is very deviating. And also, unreliable knowledge reports. People just wing it. If it sounds good, it is good. Ya Allah, help me to remember you. Why are you bringing the curse upon yourself? Do you acknowledge that you forget Allah? When in fact, it means, Ya Allah, help me to mention your name. This is the dhikr. I have mentioned this before and I still see people say, remembrance of Allah. Who are you to forget Allah? When you look in Al-Quran, you find that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala threatens the people who forget Him. Wrong translations, and I've already covered this, my brothers and my sisters. Look at the Sahaba. They didn't translate Islam for around 900 years. The Muslims never translated Islam until it got to Turkey. When it got to the Khilafah of the Uthmaniyah, the Islam got translated. And that's when it started losing everything. My brothers and my sisters, get to learn your language, the Arabic. Don't be fooled. Don't be fooled. Islam in English is okay. It is not okay. Intended the translations. I want to drive a point. And the hadith means something else. But I want to put my point across, so I use an intended ill translation so that you believe me. Because I know you don't have any way of checking the authentic sources in Arabic, nor can you read the sayings of the scholars. As I mentioned before, someone lied on Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn Taymiyyah alayhi rahmatullah, the man who recited the Quran 87 times at the end of his life, in the last year of his life. The man who memorized the Quran before 7. The man who knew al-Bukhari and Muslim, all the ahadith, both with the chain of narrators before reaching 10 years of age. The man who has been known as the miracle of Allah on earth. He was a scientist, he was a scholar in Islam, both Quran. So much so that they said a hadith unknown by Ibn Taymiyyah is not a hadith. And who says this? Al-Imam al-Dhahabi, one of his students and a great scholars of hadith. Who said this? Al-Imam Ibn Kathir, Al-Imam Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, and so many other people in his time, Ali rahmatullah, and after him. Ibn Taymiyyah, who was a scholar in Christianity, was a scholar in Judaism, was a scholar in maths, was a scholar in physics, was a scholar in geography, was a scholar in philosophy, was a scholar, name them, Ali rahmatullah. So my brothers and my sisters, you can see that these people, what they said, that he said, I wish I had read more Quran. And that is a plain lie against Ibn Taymiyyah. What Ibn Taymiyyah in fact said, he said, I wish I had written more of the tafsir of Al-Quran as Ibn Kathir, as Al-Imam al-Tabarani and Tabari and all these people, i.e. dedicate a whole book of tafsir of Ibn Taymiyyah only. But Ibn Taymiyyah alayhi rahmatullah had written a tafsir of Qul huwa Allahu Ahad in a whole book. And his books alayhi rahmatullah, without the ones that they burnt, when they calculated the books we have today, the number of pages he wrote and his lifespan, the 60 odd years, 65 years, they found out that on an average he wrote 16 pages every day of his entire life, from the time he was a baby until he died. You want to see what Ibn Taymiyyah alayhi rahmatullah wrote? Simple. Take 65 years, times them 365 days. This person here says, I wish Ibn Taymiyyah had read more Quran. Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. All these lies. Nowadays, if it sounds good, then it is good. And believe me, I can give statements of kufr and they will sound absolutely good. The moment someone sends you a clip, and on the clip there is no name, no phone number, you don't know who the person is, do not listen. Do not listen. Or those translated English things that are only written in English and underneath it Bukhari Muslim, do not listen. Because, as Rasulullah says, that a shaitan will morph into the image of a man. He will come to a people and then he will talk to them with a speech and then they will disperse from him. And the man with them would say, I've heard somebody that I know whose face, his face, but I don't know his name. This is the meaning of what your prophet said. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that today you are going to be an obstacle in the face of spreading lies. You are going to authenticate your knowledge. I'm here. Send me whatever comes to you. I will help you get the good from the bad. My brothers and my sisters, your Islam or is in, how do they bank, how do the bank say it? Yes, your house is in danger. Your Islam is in danger if you don't keep up learning Arabic and authenticating your knowledge. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. This is again your brother Abdus Salam Abu Hanifa. Telephone number 078-7640-8735. Now you understand why I give my details, because I don't want a shaitan to morph in me or to take something or to speak on my behalf. And Allah knows more. Sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.